go back and visit the brothers in all the cities where we preach the word of the Lord to them. Barnabas wanted to take John, also called Mark, with us. I did not think it wise to take him. He had deserted us in Pamphylia and not continued in the work. We had such a sharp disagreement that we parted company. Barnabas took Mark and sailed for Cyprus. I chose Silas, and we left, committed by the brothers to the work of the Lord. We traveled throughout Syria and Cilicia, strengthening the churches. We came to Derbe and then to Lystra, where we met a disciple by the name of
Timothy.
His mother was a Jewish, but his father was a Greek. Now, all the brothers at Lystra and Iconium spoke very well of him. I wanted to take him along with us on the journey, so I... I circumcised him. Well, because of all the Jews that lived in the area, everyone knew that his father was a Greek. Let's see, we traveled from town to town, delivering the decisions that were reached by the apostles and elders in Jerusalem for the people to obey. Me and my companions traveled throughout Phrygia and Galatia, having been kept by the Holy Spirit from entering the province of Asia. We came to Mysia and tried to enter Bithynia, but the Holy Spirit would not allow us. So we went on down to Troas. There, I had such a vision of a man from Macedonia. Come over to Macedonia and help us! After I'd had the vision, we got ready at once to leave for Macedonia, concluding that God wanted us to preach the gospel to them. And we stayed there several days. On the Sabbath, we went outside of the city, down to the river, where we expected to find a place of prayer. We sat down and began to talk to a group of women who had gathered there. One of those listening was a lady by the name of... She was a dealer in purple cloth from the city of Thyatira and a worshiper of God. The Lord opened her heart to the Lord's message. When she and her whole family were baptized, she invited us over to her house. She said, "If you consider me a worshiper of God, come and stay with us." We were persuaded. Once, when we were on the way to a place of prayer, we were met by a slave girl which had a spirit by which she could predict the future. Oh, her owners made a great deal of money from her fortune teller. She began to follow me, yelling out, "These men are followers of the Most High God, showing you the way to be saved." She kept this up day after day. I became so frustrated, I said, "In the name of Jesus, come out!" At once, the spirit left her. Well, when the owners realized that their hope of making any money from her was gone, they seized Silas and I and brought us into the marketplace. They brought us before the magistrates and they told him, "These men are Jews, turning our city into an uproar by advocating customs that are unlawful for us Romans to practice or accept." The whole town joined them. The magistrates ordered us stripped and beaten. After we were severely flogged, he ordered the jailer to guard us carefully. Upon receiving such orders, the jailer put us into the inner cell, fastened our feet in stocks. Silas and I didn't really have anything else to do, so we just began praying, singing hymns to our Lord. Apparently, we were a little loud, for the other prisoners were all listening in. out bitten. There came such a violent earthquake that the very foundations of the jail were shaken. Our chains fell off, the prison doors swung open. When the jailer saw that the prison doors were open, he thought that we had escaped. He drew his sword, was about to kill himself, and I said, "Wait! Wait! Don't harm yourself. We are all here." He called for lights. He came rushing in and knelt before me. What must I do to be saved? Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. You'll be saved, you and your whole household. He took us outside. We spoke a word of the Lord to he and his entire family. He washed our wounds immediately. They were all baptized. He brought us into his house, set such a meal before us. He was full of joy. He had become to know and worship God, he and his entire family. It was daylight. The magistrate sent some of their officers and told the jailer to release this man. The jailer said that we were free to leave and go in peace. I said, "Wait just a minute." They beat us publicly. Even though we were Roman citizens, they threw us into jail. Now they want to get rid of us privately? I don't think so. Let them come themselves and escort us out. When the magistrates heard that we were Roman citizens, of course, they were alarmed. They came to appease us, and they asked us to leave the city. We did. Well, after we went back to Lydia's house and encouraged the brothers, and then we left. We'll speak again on this subject.